New tonight, the family of the 16-year-old killed yesterday while playing with a gun says they don't know where Lakato Leach could have gotten that weapon. 16 WAPT's Meg Pace talked to his family, including his little brother, who was with him when that tragic accident happened.
Well, Stephanie, as you can imagine, this family says they're getting through this huge loss with just a lot of prayer. And they describe Lakato as an easygoing teen who loves sports and Facebook. But one thing they don't understand tonight, why he was playing with a gun in the first place.
Put one bullet in it, and he had clicked blood, me and my friend.
14-year-old Demian Leach was right next to his brother Lakato when the 16-year-old shot himself in the head. He was playing with a revolver.
But he just playing though.
Police say they're investigating whether the Lanier High freshman was playing Russian roulette. But regardless, this mother has lost her oldest son.
He was a good person. He wasn't no good child, never stayed in trouble, nothing like that. He was a sweet person.
Shanice Leach says when she got the devastating call Thursday, she couldn't get to her children fast enough.
Hit by 9, they're going to the scene.
This was the scene that Lakato's mom rushed to. The three boys were playing inside this press box when that revolver went off. Families who live near Grove Park say a stronger police presence in the area could have stopped this deadly accident.
Who's patrolling the park? Nobody. 16-year-old gone.
Lakato's classmates at Lanier are trying to grasp the fact that the teen the family describes as easygoing is gone. What went through your mind when you heard about it?
I didn't believe it.
And now Shanice Leach is trying to set a strong example for her youngest son, helping him cope after witnessing the death of his big brother.
It was a hurting feeling, but you know, I still had to stay strong. I just don't know why he'll want to play with a gun like that, but
yeah,
I'm just being strong. That's all I can do.
Lakato's mom also told me tonight she has no idea where he could have gotten that gun. She said she doesn't own a gun or keep any in the house, so that's something police are working on tonight. Stephanie, they want to know how this weapon got into a teenager's hands.
Many prayers for that family tonight. All right, Meg, thank you so much.